Hi, I'm John Wilson and I'm really thrilled about these new Rovex lines, now sold through Masterline Walker, because there's such choice in both freshwater and sea fishing options. Virtually all of my boat fishing at sea, both at home and around the world, has benefited enormously through using braided reel lines. Whether uptiding, when an enormous bow of line has to be taken up, lure fishing, or simply downtide boat fishing. My choice for lure fishing, especially when working shads and perks etc. at great depths, is Rovex Airstrike braid, which has got zero stretch, really zero stretch, and it's got a very round profile so it doesn't bed down in between the other coils. Then there's Turgo, which is a Dyneema braid with a very high strength to diameter ratio. And then we have the new multicoloured depth finder braid in 10 meter sections of blue, orange, green, red and purple, which is also marked in yellow and black every meter. The applications of this line are absolutely endless. Now let me show you how to join braid and monofilament of roughly the same diameter together using the very reliable double five turn uni knot. Now to start, hold the two ends of each line alongside each other, and starting with the braid, come round in a loop and go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and pull into a very loose barrel knot, turn it around, and we do the same with the mono. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and again pull into a loose barrel knot. Now we pull them together, and when they're together, we then pull each of the tag ends just to tighten them, and then pull lastly together, which beds the knot completely down. That's lovely. And there we are with the finished knot. All we need to do now is just trim the ends off, but not too close, with a pair of braid scissors. Now for monofilament, and my favourite by far is Rovex 10X formula, which is 10 times more abrasion resistant than other lines. Great for fishing over rocks and shingle etc. And remember, in Australia, where this line originated from, they do an awful lot of shore fishing over rough ground. Then we have the premium line, made using Japanese copolymers, which makes for very good casting. In fact, I've just put it onto my reel. And as all shore anglers use shock leaders, let me give you two options for knots. Adding a 24 foot length of 60 pounds Rovex Hi-Vis special surf shock leader. Let's start with a simple beach caster knot by tying just one knot in the 60 pound shock leader, poking the 20 pound reel line through, turning it around, and then really tightening that knot up. Now I wet the 20 pound reel line and pull it through. Just tighten it a fraction more. Now we do a five turn uni knot around both the leader and 3, 4, 5 around the monofilament, and then we pull it down nice and tight to that. Pull now both on the tag end of the shock leader and the tag end of the reel line. Nice and tight. There we are. All we do now is simply trim off the end fairly close, because you don't want it catching on your rod rings, with a pair of snips, and we can cut off the tag end of the mono with a pair of scissors or the snips. There we are. And there's the standard beach caster knot. Now we come to what I think is actually a better, smoother knot for shock leader fishing. And we start by doubling the leader over into a loop, putting the reel line through, and pulling off about 6 or 7 inches for a tag end. And then we have to go around the loop 13 times. 2, just hold it every now and again. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, hold it again, 11, 12, 13. Now it's important that the tag end goes back through the same side that the reel line entered. And now you can see the strength of the knot. We'll just pull on the line. See how it's tightening up really nice and evenly. You can pull on this end just like that. All the coils need to be nice and straight. And you can pull on both of them now really, really tightly. And that's the Albright, which goes through the rod rings, I think, backwards and forwards much more easily. You don't cut the reel line too short, but you can cut the doubled line really, really short, as short as you like. I use this same knot, incidentally, for joining thick monofilament to fine braid. Now there's the knot. That's really, really reliable. And here are the two knots I've just tied in close up. You can see that the beach caster knot, though smaller, because the end of the shot leader stands out at right angles a little bit, tends to catch when it goes through rod rings now and again. Whereas the Albright, although it's bulkier, is much, much smoother. And I think, if anything, that would be my choice.